Hey folks, welcome to Teddy Tech TV. I've got the Lenovo C940 2-in-1 laptop teed up for review, and I think Lenovo's made a number of really well-considered decisions here, though there are still a thing or two that I would improve. The laptop's got a minimal aesthetic, but it's still beautiful and functional. If you want to find out more, come with me. The model I've got has an Intel i7-1065G7, a 14-inch IPS display, 12GB of RAM, 512GB SSD, and integrated graphics. So this particular model is on sale right now for $1,699 Canadian, though the regular price is $1,899, and that's a model with 12GB of RAM that I've got here. If you want to buy directly from Lenovo, you can get a model that is spec'd exactly the same, except it only has 8GB of RAM for $1,679 Canadian, or $1,849 at regular price. Compare that to a similarly spec'd Dell XPS 13 2-in-1 with 16GB of RAM instead of 8GB, and you're looking at $1,949 Canadian on sale and $1,699 US. All right, let's take a closer look at the way this thing is built. The all-metal machine enclosure weighs just 1.35 kilograms or 2.98 pounds, and it looks gorgeous, especially in the light, though it does pick up fingerprints like gangbusters. As for ports, we've got two Thunderbolt 3 ports, both of which can be used for charging, and the handy little charging light right next door to them, a USB 3.1 port, and a headphone jack. And then on the other side, no ports, but a power button with an LED recessed into it. There's a really nice feel to it. The hinge is nice and stiff as well, and incorporates this really neat and striking soundbar. Underneath, you've got full-length rubber pads for support, and in the back, there is the pen garage, which holds and charges the stylus, which we'll take a closer look at later. So this is a 14-inch laptop that's a 14-inch IPS display, and though it's not the absolute best display I've seen on a laptop, it's still really nice. Now this is the 1080p model I've got with a resolution of 1920 by 1080 and an aspect ratio of 16 by 9. Not my favorite aspect ratio. I would have liked to see 16 by 10 on this, although 3 by 2 is my favorite aspect ratio on any laptop. The full HD display is capable of 100% sRGB and 400 nits of brightness and is a touchscreen, and you can upgrade to a 4K UHD display that's capable of 500 nits of brightness for $250 Canadian or $200 US, but you're going to take a serious hit to battery life. One other thing you want to keep in mind is that this laptop is really prone to reflections. I don't know if it has any non-reflective coating, but if it does, it doesn't work very well, so you need to keep that in mind when using it in well-lit spaces. This is a 2-in-1, which actually means it has three different functions. Go figure. So there's laptop mode, which is the traditional clamshell laptop. There's tent mode, where you basically flip the keyboard around so you can prop it up on both the keyboard and the display. When you do this, the speakers are all still in really good positions. Soundbar actually becomes an upward-facing speaker, and the two speakers on the bottom become forward-facing, and this is a perfect mode for watching video like Netflix or YouTube. It's just really comfortable. The screen looks great in this mode, and it's great to get the keyboard out of the way sometimes. And then there's tablet mode, which turns it into a large 16 by 9 tablet, which is the thing it does least well, really. I mean, the screen is just too tall in tablet mode. The laptop is just sort of too heavy to carry, especially one-handed. You have the pen, and the way it's garaged and the charges while it's in its garage is really nice, but it's not spring-loaded, and to be honest, from some angles, it's actually kind of hard to remove. Now let's talk about the keyboard and the trackpad. The keyboard is something that I really, really like about this laptop. It's something I like about all Lenovo laptops, especially ThinkPads, and this laptop does a good job as well. The keys are all really stable, they have good travel, they feel pillowy when you press them, and not mushy, and there's two levels of backlighting here. The trackpad is pretty good for a Windows laptop. It's not the best. It's got a fairly solid click, but only when you're clicking at the bottom of the trackpad. The whole trackpad doesn't click, so if you try clicking in the middle or the top, you get very little travel in it, and it's kind of uncomfortable. There is a fingerprint reader as well, and the fingerprint reader read my fingerprint perfectly every time. It's in a good place. I like it here much better than as part of the trackpad or along the side of a laptop. This laptop performs really well, which isn't surprising considering the 10th generation i7 processor that's in here, and it can easily handle any productivity tasks you might throw at it. So this 4-core, 8-thread processor regularly runs at 1.3 gigahertz, though it turbo boosts to 3.9 gigahertz, and that gets you a Geekbench 5 score of 1,299 single core and 4,331 multi-core. On PCMARK 10, which measures sort of an overall productivity workflow, you're looking at 4,502. Now the storage in here is the fast NVMe kind. So you're looking at sequential reads of 3,563 megabytes per second and sequential writes of 2,979 megabytes per second. The Wi-Fi spec is good too. It supports Wi-Fi 6. Now, as for graphics performance, this is an integrated GPU, so don't expect anything crazy, but graphics performance actually isn't that bad. If you run games at low to medium settings and you don't expect miracles, then you can get decent performance on games that are a few years old. And yes, it can play Fortnite. Another area where this laptop just shines is battery life, and that's something that people who are looking for this class of laptop are really going to appreciate, I think. On PCMARK 8, which is an artificial benchmark, which runs the laptop through a constant productivity workload, the laptop scored 5 hours and 56 minutes, which, though it doesn't sound like a lot, is actually the most I've measured on any laptop I've reviewed. And this is an artificial benchmark, so in real-world use, you could actually expect several hours more. And finally, I want to talk about the speakers, because that's something that, at least from a marketing perspective, kind of sets this laptop apart. It's got that Dolby Atmos branded soundbar. It's really hard to judge speakers or a soundbar over YouTube, but I'm going to tell you, these speakers sound really good. They've got a great sort of deep low end, and because of the number and placement of speakers, there's the two on the bottom and then there's the soundbar, and the way that they move when you move from mode to mode, you get pretty good sound and pretty good coverage in both laptop mode and tent mode. Not so much in tablet mode, which covers up the two speakers on the bottom and sees the soundbar sort of pointing out to the side. So at the end of this review, what's the take home message? Well, if it isn't already clear, I think this is an excellent buy, especially if you already know that you want this sort of two-in-one type of laptop. I really enjoyed the ability to put it into tent mode, though I think tablet mode is something people will use a lot less. If you compare it to the Dell XPS 13 2-in-1, it's actually significantly cheaper, though that model has slightly better spec'd display. Now, Lenovo tends to have a decent number of sales, so I would suggest waiting it out. Don't pay full price for this laptop. Get it on sale, and it'll be an excellent value.